service fronts. And today we're going to talk about producer surplus. And we know producer surplus is the way that economists measure the welfare of producers from participating in the market. And by definition, individual producer surplus is equal to price, so that's the equilibrium price of the good or service, minus cost. So the cost is the cost the producer incurs in producing that good or service. And we're going to start with a mini market of a babysitting service. So suppose currently the babysitting service is $15 per hour, and we have a mini market where we have sitters including Allison, Bill, Charlie, David, and Eliza. And their cost of producing or providing this babysitting service is $12 for Allison. That's Allison's cost, including her opportunity cost. And Bill's cost is $13, Charlie's $14, and so on and so forth. So we can calculate their individual producer surplus by subtracting cost from the price. And notice that you will only provide this babysitting service if your cost is less than or equal to the price. Otherwise, if your cost is too high, for example, like Eliza, her cost is $16 and the current price is $15. So Eliza will not enter this market to provide the service. So you can see that Eliza is not in the market, and therefore, if you're not participating in the market, then your producer surplus is going to be zero. So Eliza's producer surplus is equal to zero. And Allison, from Allison to Debbie, you can see their costs are less than or equal to $15. So Allison, Bill, Charlie, and Debbie, they will provide this babysitting service. And their producer surplus is, for Allison, is equal to price 15 minus the cost $12. So you can see Allison's producer surplus is equal to $3. And Bill's producer surplus is equal to price, $15, minus Bill's cost, which is $13. So Bill's producer surplus is equal to $2. And so on and so forth, up to Debbie. Debbie's cost is exactly equal to $15. So whether she provides the service or not, suppose she does, then her individual producer surplus will be equal to 15 minus 15. That gives you $0 producer surplus. And we can draw their producer surplus like this. So we know the ongoing price right now is $15. And Allison's cost is $12 right here. So Allison's producer surplus will be 15 minus 12. So that will be $3. And graphically, you can see it's this block for Allison. That's her producer surplus. How about Bill? Well, Bill's cost is $13, a little higher. So Bill's producer surplus will be 15 minus 13, that gives you $2, and so on and so forth. And notice we don't just care about the producer surplus of an individual. We actually care about the producer surplus of all the producers. So we can sum that up, and in this market, the sum of their producer surplus will be 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus 0, and that gives you $6. Graphically, that will be the shaded area, the blue shaded area, that will be the market's producer surplus. And now we know in reality the market is a lot bigger than just say just four sellers, right? We have a lot of sellers in this market. Think about it. For example, Houston, we have lots of babysitters who are trying to look for jobs. Now, when you have a lot of sellers, then your steps that reflect the cost of the producers will become really, really tiny like this. And tiny steps, each step represent one seller. And guess what? It's actually just the supply curve that you're familiar with. So now you know supply curve actually reflects the cost of producers. And in the next mini video, I'm going to show you how to represent, how to show producer surplus using supply curve. For now, I hope this helps, and thank you for watching. Good luck with your studying.